Today's video is all about this guy. This is the Genmitsu Z5-1 fiber laser. Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the Genmitsu Z5-1, another desktop fiber laser that's being offered, fairly new to the market, and take an in-depth look, material test, talk about the pros and cons and everything about it. As far as packaging, unboxing, and assembly, I have zero complaints and really zero things to really talk about. You have everything you need right there in that box, from the machine, the components, the accessories, the tools, and the full color instructions. They got you covered. All right, so let's take a look at this thing here real time. The way I have it set up is it's standard configuration where you're going to be engraving on the bed here, the base down here below. If I wanted to switch this around to engrave something, say this tabletop I'm working on, it doesn't have a removal base here, so what they've got you designed is you take out this thumb screw, and then you flip the machine around. At that point, the actual surface it's sitting on becomes the base or the engraving area. Very easy to do. While I have this apart, I'll go ahead and show you guys their handheld portable base that you get. This little guy here, first off, it's got a built-in safety shield that is awesome, but it's not just a plastic and that's it. There is an anodized aluminum top and bottom plate with a built-in exhaust port fan, which is very cool. As far as assembly, it is the exact same way that you assemble the base and just connect this machine to anything. You've got the two little tabs that lock in just like that, and you take the large thumb screw, put it in here through the bottom. Then this little cord plugs up to the back, right here on the back where it says fan port. And then you're good to go. That's it. If you notice, you guys see that? You see what's happening here? This thing is standing on its own. This is its free standing handheld engraving mode, but it is designed with this big metal base with the rubber feet. It's self-supporting. That is really good. That's an upgrade from other lasers I've tested on this channel. As far as real life functionality and practicality of this, I'm not really sure when I would use this. I'm obviously not going to do the handheld engraving thing I'd like to show you, but it being able to sit like that perfectly fine with a base, that's usable. That's doable. So I don't know if the day ever comes that I want to engrave some kind of a workbench or a toolbox or something like that, but if it does arrive, I know I can get it done with this. I like the fact that they include an exhaust port. That's pretty cool. Not so much from a get the fumes out of the way because it's going to put it right in your face, but it's nice because it gets the fumes out of the way from in here and allows the laser to continue working as well as it needs to. As smoke and fumes build up, it's going to affect your laser's performance. So it's very nice they included the fan, knowing that ahead of time, to know to pull it out of the way, give you the best result possible. The one thing I will note really quickly, when I was unboxing this, the safety shields come with like a plastic film over them. When I went to pull them off, anywhere the plastic has been bent, I'm assuming they heated it up and kind of formed it and bent it, some of that clear plastic is like stuck on there. So I had to scrape it off around the corners. It's my only complaint about this, and that's really, honestly, very minor. Here on the main machine, the main body of everything, you have a USB cable that goes from your power lift. Yes, powered lift. From there, it plugs into the back of the machine, and the little USB port labeled Z port just plugs in just like that. And that gives you, over here on this side, a little up and down button. As you press it, it raises and lowers. No clunky hand cranks, no manual adjustments. Very, very nice. This is an unexpected feature and one that is honestly really nice. As you're seeing it here as I throw this thing around, it is very portable. It's relatively lightweight, but it is also a strong and secure construction. I don't feel like I'm gonna break this thing. I have no problems picking it up like it is. There's plenty of grab areas, the handle on top, the lift arm, the base, everywhere except for the lens and the USB cable, you're gonna be good. This is a well-built machine, very strong and sturdy, has a great fit and finish, and honestly, feels really robust. If you look closely here at the base, you'll see a grid mark, or a little grid. That is not original. You don't get that with the machine out of the box. But if you just design it and run it in your program, you can give yourself your own grid board. Pretty cool. I decided to do that because I accidentally engraved my base one time and figured, you know what? Let's make it look intentional and not accidental. So I just gave myself a grid board. A simple 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter square spacing and a typical crosshairs across the middle gives me good functionality. Sorry guys, I gotta jump in here real quick. I finished the video and I forgot to mention one of the best things about the machine. This, the included laser safety shield is wonderful. This is the missing link of other models similar to this. They don't take your safety into account. They figure, you know what? Good luck, Buttercup. That right there. This little guy is so awesome. It really takes it up a notch. It allows me to be safe from our workshop. It allows other people to be safer. It is just a great addition. Surely it doesn't cost the company that much to add it. The fact that Genmitsu does it is amazing. Also like the fact that it is modular. You know, I could put it this way, no problem. It covers it full width. Might be a better way to use it. It all depends on the way you set up your machine and use it. What's cool about this is you can set it up wherever it works best for your workflow. For me personally, the laser is usually to the right of me, so doing this completely encases the entire laser area behind the shield. If I was more directly in front of it, maybe I would want it like that. Perfect, no problem. Still enough room to reach around the side here, put the piece in place. And likewise, if you're left-handed or working this way, you can do it that way too. So I just want to interject real quick and say that this piece right here, very, very nice. I just plugged up the power to the back of the machine here. It's a standard DC plug here, barrel port connection. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the machine on by pressing the power button. The fan does run all the time, so it is noisy. Nothing too bad, but on camera, it's gonna pick it up pretty well. What I want to illustrate for you guys is the maximum height. How much distance, how tall of an object can you put on the base plate and still engrave it and get it to focus? First thing first, let's go ahead and dial it in here at the base. See what the smallest object, or at least the focal distance from the tabletop to the lens. Very roughly, it's at 5 1/4 inches from lens to tabletop. Let's go ahead and raise this thing all the way up, subtract 5 1/4, and see what kind of height we get. Holy laser elevation, Batman. Go ahead and turn this thing off so you can hear me a little bit better. That is quite the Z height difference. Let's see what we got here. Roughly 10 1/4, a little bit less. So you know what? Let's round off here and there. Let's say that you've got 4 1/2 inches of working height. So an object 4 1/2 inches tall, you can sit on this base, still get it focused and engrave it. That is pretty cool. That is actually a very extreme amount of Z height, a lot more than I thought it was going to do. Very cool. Now, the other thing, at this height, how wobbly, how loose and everything is it? It's just as rock solid as down below. So whatever mechanism they have in here, let's take a peek, see if we can figure it out. Ha ha ha, it's a lead screw. So they're using a lead screw in here and that thing is rock solid. There's no slop, there's no movement in that, there's no jiggly parts, and that is very, very cool. While I'm lowering this thing back down to its base position, let me throw a few little tech specs at you guys. This is the Genmitsu Z5-1 fiber laser. It is made of anodized aluminum. It is a 1064 nanometer laser, powering at about 2 watts, an overall working size of 70 millimeters squared. It uses a dual red dot lasers for focusing, has powered lift, and includes safety shields as well as safety goggles. So notable features of the machine, obviously from what you see, there is a button here at the top. If you press this, it'll rerun the same job you just did. That is phenomenal if you're doing a lot of batch productions, a lot of engravings, the same thing over and over and over. Load it up, press, engrave, take it off, new one, press, new one, over, over, over. No more back and forth to computers. That is very handy. Over here on the left, we have the intake for the fan, as well as the Genmitsu logo. Otherwise, a very clean looking appearance, nice looking machine. The front has an LED status light. Whenever you turn it on, it lights up blue, so that is cool. Over here on the right side of the machine is nothing much to note other than the two buttons for raising and lowering for focusing. And then as we spin it around to the back, we have the power on off switch, the USB cable input for the Z lift, the USB cable input for the fan for the handheld setup, power inlet, and a USB-C connection which goes to your PC for communication. There is a small little black looking switch and a little port cover below that over here on the right side of the machine. I asked the company what that's for and they said nothing, ignore it. So just ignore it, it's nothing, you don't see that. I don't know, who knows what it really is, not me. Otherwise, spinning it around, as you guys can see, it's a pretty nice little small laser package. The 70 by 70 millimeter work area is probably the number one limitation of this thing. We're looking at a roughly 3.5 inch square for those of us in the US, and it's not a ginormous working area. But for a machine this size with this power rating, it does pretty good. It at least fits with the machine. Sure, we would love to have a larger working area, but something such as that would need larger mirror housings, a bigger galvanometer setup, and probably just means an overall bigger machine. So there's an overview of the machine, a little bit hands-on time. Now let's jump over to our material test. Let this thing run through some tests so you guys can see how it goes through, get those materials, and then show you the results real time. Very similarly to other infrared 1064 nanometer lasers, this machine will work on stone, plastic, metal, and non-organic based materials. Things such as wood, raw wood, it won't really have an effect on. However, if you paint that wood, you can then engrave the painting. So this is a little bit of a workaround. If you have, say, wood coasters in this case, if you get a light coat of a paint, you can engrave it and give yourself a nice dark finish that is visible and allows you to overcome at least that one particular obstacle that you get with an infrared laser. Otherwise, things such as slate, absolutely no problem. Things such as this artistic scratch art paper, no problem at all. That stuff was very, very easy to run. Items such as plastic, whether it be dark or light, is no problem at all for a machine. As is tool plastic. This is some injection plastic, I believe, is kind of injection mold. No issues there engraving that. And of course, anodized and aluminum, no problems. That's a Samcraft logo on a flashlight. And then this little tiger guy on an aluminum business card, that turned out really, really sharp and nice. As far as metal engraving goes, I have my sheet of aluminum here, and running at 100% power, this went as fast as 2000 millimeters per second and still did a wonderful job engraving the aluminum. As you look through the shade or the grid of power, you can see it does really good. And honestly, anything from 400 and up gives you a nice light color. Looking at brass here, is a very similar result as with aluminum. It worked fine all the way up to 2000 millimeters per second. Probably the sweet spot or the best looking one is around 400 millimeters per second, just as my personal taste. But as you can see here, if you went even slower, you did get kind of a tarnishing and colorization effect. So that's something you may be interested in. You can check it out and see it here as well. Copper is notoriously difficult to engrave because of its power hungriness, because it acts as a great heat sink, robbing your laser of its effective power. However, with this laser and the copper sheet, I didn't really have any problems. I still got good results at 2000 millimeters a second. And as far as the best looking quality without getting too dark, 500 to 400 millimeters a second seemed like a pretty good spot. Now, I also have the option, as you'll see here, running a lot slower to get some different colorization effects and some really dark, dark engravings. Around 100 millimeters a second, you kind of get a blue. Around the 300 millimeter second, you kind of maybe get a little bit of rose color. And then if you want to go as slow as 10 millimeters a second, you get a really, really nice dark engraving. While I did not test this particular machine with things such as tool steel, stainless steel, and hardened steel, I know for a fact the 1064 nanometer lights and lasers that are in this thing will engrave them at no problem. So I'm very confident saying this machine will do that too. So I've had the Genmitsu Z5-1 for about a month and a half now, and I've been using it a lot for some products that I make and sell. I've actually been using it to engrave slate. It is super fast at that. I can do with this machine in a couple of minutes what would take other machines several minutes. But what I really like about this is setting it up with its included fence and doing repeat jobs. For smaller objects, it is great for just plopping it, engraving it, swapping out my piece, pushing the button to engrave, over and over and over. This is a great little miniature assembly line machine to have in a workshop for your small business or your side hustle. This thing's really nice. Having used this machine for over a month, there are three things I do not like. First and foremost is the working size. 70 millimeters by 70 millimeters is just a little bit too small. Honestly, if they would just step that up enough to give you a 4-inch by 4-inch square, that would really meet 95% of the needs of most people, rather in my market and similar markets, as far as small scale business engraving and doing that kind of work. The other thing I don't like is the dual focus lasers for focusing. They are not exactly right where the center point for the laser will be. What that means, if you have a small object, let's say the screwdriver, for example, I went to engrave it, I had to move it forward, focus, and then move it back for the job. I wish that the focusing lasers were at the same point as the center point laser that fires. It's a small thing, I know, but it is something that I didn't like. Last but not least on the things that I don't like, this machine, as of the making of the video, is not Lightburn compatible. You do have to use CCAD for this laser. However, if you have seen my other video of a similar sized 1064 nanometer laser, you will know that the version CCAD, BSL CAD that came with that machine was pretty terrible. I will tell you this much, the version you get with this machine, whatever version is on that USB stick that Genmitsu sends you, is amazing. It may have the same name, but it's not the same program. It is very user friendly, very easy to use. All the menus are in English, the help files are intact, and it has a lot more features than the other version. So don't let this not being Lightburn compatible scare you away from using it. The software that comes with this is user friendly. While it is not Lightburn standard, it is still a software piece that is very manageable, has a lot of features, and is pretty easy to learn. Don't get hung up on the no Lightburn, because honestly, this machine has a lot of pros to outweigh that, and it's really not a big deal in the end. There you have it, guys. There's the Genmitsu Z5-1, a fiber laser engraver machine, if you will, a 1064 nanometer galvometer laser. This machine, honestly, is really nice. For the price point and the size and the capabilities, the included accessories and functionality, it beats the pants off of any other one I've seen in the market as of the making of this video. So if you're in the market for looking for an infrared laser, something to engrave metal, work with slate and things in a faster method, when you're okay with that smaller footprint size, this could be the machine for you. As always, there's a link to this machine down below if you want to check it out, as well as my other laser review videos, ones possibly similar to this one. You can kind of see it and judge apples to apples which one looks better. But for me, this guy is the new favorite of the workshop. Well, guys, if you got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Otherwise, appreciate you watching. As always, take care, and I'll see you next time in the workshop. Come on, buddy. You're going to Laser Town. Back to Laser Town. It's been at Laser Town for a month and a half.